Hey, morning. Welcome back to Creator on Wheels. I'm Shiv. And it's a beautiful Sunday morning. It's 7:30 a.m. And I am out doing what most pro riders would do on a Sunday morning, which is go for a breakfast ride. Yeah. And unfortunately, I'm riding solo today. Unfortunately, because a couple of my friends are supposed to join me for this ride. So there was a plan for 3-4 of us to go out this morning, but the weather was a little bit unpredictable over the last few days, especially in the evenings. Even last evening it rained quite badly, so folks were a little bit apprehensive about getting stuck in rain if we go out, and the worst thing being not able to go out because of a rain or a drizzle in the morning. So they called off the plans last night, but I was kind of like mentally prepared that even if it drizzles, I'll probably go out for a short ride, even if not for a breakfast ride. So here I am out on NH4, which is Nelamangala Tumkur Road to be more precise, and probably heading towards Kunigal. I'll take a deviation after Nelamangala so that I can go towards the Kunigal Ediyur or the Mangalore Road and stop over for breakfast based on how crowded or not crowded the restaurant is. So I've not decided on any specific place as of now, because it's a Sunday morning and it's a beautiful weather. So I'm pretty sure a lot of people will be out now. Even if not for breakfast ride, they might be wanting to go for a day outing or something like that. So I am expecting a little bit of crowd in most of the restaurants. So based on which of those is less crowded, I'll decide to go there. So that's the plan for today. So let's see how things go. Not really sure about what I should do after the breakfast. I've not decided on any place. But the weather is absolutely fantastic. I think this is the first time I'm telling in today's video the word fantastic. And you might hear me say a few gazillion times, but yes, it is fantastic. Not really as cold as what I expected. Perfect for riding, perfect for driving as well. So let's see how the day goes. I'll keep you posted. Now it's time to answer one big question that I get asked regarding my bike very frequently. The last couple of times I went out, that was like just before and after the second wave lockdown, I posted a few pictures and people immediately started messaging me, "Oh, you modified your bike again. What happened to the previous handlebar? Was it not good? You changed the grab rail, was it not good? Why have you changed this? Why have you changed that?" Short answer is, it's not because something is bad that I change. Sometimes I feel that these kind of changes kind of make the bike look and feel new, and that's exactly what I want. I don't want to get bored, because once I get bored of seeing the same stuff, then I'll probably kind of lose interest or something on it. So I kind of change these smaller nitty-gritty things. Maybe sometimes I want to go back to something old because it was more comfortable than what it is now. But I do my own groundwork before doing any change, and then I change it. And as most of you would have seen, most of these changes are kind of, I would say, aesthetic and definitely not mechanical. I never do anything mechanical on my bike, either this one or any of my previous bike, or probably anything that I buy in the future also. Mechanical changes that I would refrain from doing, because you would have done your homework and then only you would have bought your bike. You don't have to buy a bike and then modify it to suit your needs. That's one perspective that I have. And when I say aesthetic, or maybe I would say a little bit of functional, it's things to do like this handlebar or grab rail or the saddle stay or probably even this super expensive windscreen that I have, which is absolutely useless when it comes to the functionality aspect. So I keep doing this. Now let's take like one part at a time. The first most thing that I got bombarded with when it came to my bike thing was the handle. I was one of the first guys probably to get the AIM handlebar on my Java 42. And I think I've convinced quite a lot of people to get it changed in the groups that I'm a part of. Most questions they are like, were you not happy, were you not comfortable? No, it has nothing to do with that. There are two reasons. One quick and straightforward thing is, just before the second wave lockdown started, I had this thought process of modifying my bike to give it more of like that scrambler look. And when I say scrambler, I didn't wanted a motocross handlebar on it. I didn't wanted a very traditional classic look on it or anything. So I had already made up my mind that I will remove the handlebar and I'll keep it with me, and I will remove the saddle stay, and I will remove the backrest or the carrier or whatever you want to call it. So that research had started already, and I had spoken to a few of my close friends who are into this modification, and I was started evaluating the cost and how long it takes and how good or bad it is. Everything I was evaluating already, including tire changes. Exactly at the same time, a friend of mine reached out on a WhatsApp group telling that he is going on a K2K ride on his Java 42. He too has a Nebula 2 Java 42, same batch. So he wanted to do a Kanyakumari to Kashmir on a Java 42. Okay, my first response was, why do you want to do such thing on a such small capacity or a non-adventure bike? More of like a retro classic and kind of a bike, why do you want to do it? But yeah, he was sure of whatever he had decided. Okay, long thing short, he reached out telling that he wanted to get information about the saddle stay, the handlebar, comfort handlebar for Java 42, all those things for longer rides. And we both were discussing on WhatsApp regarding my experience, where I got and how much it costed and all those stuff. And it kind of struck me that I'll probably propose it to him that if he's interested in picking up my own saddle stay and the handlebar. The reason being, whatever I had planned last year, because of which I wanted the saddle stay and the luggage mounting system, and even for that matter, even the handlebar, I have changed that plan. So the decision is that I might or I will not be using this bike for any long distance touring or anything which involves more than 300-400 kilometers in a day, or maybe it's like a multi-day bike trip. I will not use this bike because my gut feeling is that this is not the best of the bikes, this is not the right bike to do that. So I asked him if he's interested in my own saddle stay, and I think I did tell him about the handle, but I just told him about the saddle stay, and he outright told, if you're ready to give, then I'm fine, I'm ready to take. Because he had a very short window, I think he had just about a week or so left for him to start moving out of Bangalore and start preparing for his trip, and he didn't have time to give the bike for the saddle stay manufacturing or whatever you can call it. So we met once, he came down to my place, and he saw the bike, and he liked the look of my bike. That's exactly what I I've done the modification for, like, one, it should look good. Like, I think it should be functional, it should have some use, otherwise why the hell you don't do it? He was convinced and he told that he is ready to take the saddle stay, and I mean out of like very casual instinct, I just asked him if he's interested in my handlebar as well. Because this thought was running in my mind that I should change my handlebar to do that scrambler modification and all those stuff. He told if you're ready and if you're fine, give it. He was very frank with that, like, if I'm not missing anything and if I'm comfortable giving it off, give it. So I just told him I'll take a day or two to decide, because when I want to do that, the so-called scrambler modification, it involves a little bit of money and a little bit of time that the bike has to be away from me, and I wanted to make sure that I'm comfortable with that. And we were not at all sure about all this second wave and all those things, and we were not sure that we will be locked up in our houses once again. So I just took a couple of days time, and I messaged him back that yes, I'm fine with that. So I decided to give away the handle, the AM handlebar, the knuckle guard and the saddle stay to him. So he came down to my house, I had got everything removed, and I gave it to him and he took it. But while doing that, there was one another calculation that was going on since last several months, like from the point when I changed it, that I wanted to try the Perak handle on a Java 42. So this particular handle, what you see here, this is a Java Perak handlebar. So Java now has, I would probably say, three handlebars. One is your Java 42 handlebar, which is flat and straight, wide one. Next is the Java classic handlebar, which is exactly same as what you're seeing here, but that's a Chrome version. And this is the Java Perak handlebar. So I had decided that I will change it, because I knew that the Java 42 handlebar is not the best of the handlebar. It looks good, but it is not comfortable, is what I had felt. Especially for my type of physique, it was definitely not comfortable, and that's the reason why I had changed the handlebar in the very beginning of the time when I took the bike. Now I reached out to service center, they told they have stock, so I just swapped it. So when I got my bike handle removed, I swapped it with a Perak handle then and there, and since then I've been using it. It is good. Okay, it's not extraordinary, it is not like too good or comparable with anything best in the world, but it's good, that's all I would say. So that is the reason why I changed a few of the things on my bike, and why you see the handlebar missing and why you see the saddle stay missing on my bike. Now with regard to the backrest, the ring style what I have, or the basic style what I have, is the third backrest that I've been having. I had one in the beginning which was bought out of desperation, because my wife and my mom were not at all comfortable sitting on the bike without a backrest, and so it was like a desperate move, and there were hardly any backrest available in the first few months of me picking up the bike. So that was one desperate purchase, just like huge, bulky, a little bit ugly looking, out of place for the bike, serving my purpose, so I had it. Then when more and more companies started doing backrest, I felt that the one which was manufactured by Quality Industries, that was one of the best of the lot. But still I feel, if not for the plain simple one that I have now, the one that is done by the Quality Industries, Quality Metal Industries in Chennai, that is, they have some of the best looking backrest in the market. I frankly don't like the ones from the Zana or few other companies which I've seen on the Instagram. It looks like totally out of place and not very aesthetically done. So why I changed that is, like, the carrier, I had a plan of putting that small studs vault box on top of it, and there I would carry my breakfast ride items on it. Things like water bottle, or maybe extra pair of gloves, sanitizer, mask, and maybe a few snacks, chocolates, or protein bar kind of a thing that I wanted to carry there. And I did that for a couple of rides. It was absolutely a disastrous decision because two times when I took edible items in it, all thanks to the temperature and the numerous rides over bumpy roads, it was a mess. It was like a dirty mess inside that box. So it was, I just like, the very first time I thought it is because of the temperature, that the weather was too hot, that's why things have got messed up inside. I mean, the chocolate had melted and the juice that I had carried were all like, it was like totally mess. I don't even know what to explain it because it was gross. But when it happened for the second time also, then I got to know that, yeah, it is not something which is useful for the type of thing that I want to carry. Maybe it was right to carry tools in that, and that's exactly how I've kept it now. I kept that box filled with all the tools that I would need for my Java 42. But I don't think so I'll be fitting it back on the bike anytime soon. So that carrier was like something which I didn't need it anymore. And the backrest, I felt that, okay, I can't just cut off the carrier part and just keep the backrest. So I thought, like, why not put something more basic, which is the simple ring kind of a thing that is there right now. I thought, like, instead of completely removing it, let me put the ring style one, and that's the reason for changing it. So there is no other big hangama creating reason that that backrest was not good, the quality and all those things. I still have that, and if I really need it and if I really want to carry the Struts vault box, I might still go back and put it in. I changed it myself, this backrest, so it's something which I can do it in like 15 minutes or 13 minutes, so I might change it, but very unlikely, because as I told you, might not use this bike for longer rides and all those things. So yeah, that, I think that answers the story. So that's it. That's pretty much why I have changed my handlebar, why I have changed my backrest, why I have removed my saddle stay. So at this point of time, if you really ask me, when am I going to get the bike modified? Lot of thoughts going on in my mind, not regarding when, but more fear regarding all this third wave kind of a thing. Because I don't want to get into a situation wherein I give the bike for modification and I've been told that it'll take about 2 to 3 weeks, I mean 3 at the very luxury end, and during that time a lockdown happens and the bike is not with me and it is stuck in the workshop. That fear is there in my mind, which is preventing me from taking the decision. So I'll take a tab on how the things are and then do it. I definitely want to do it, but it is a question of when and if all things are fine. And if they can do it in a week, then I would probably do it, because who doesn't, like, who likes to keep their bike out of their house and out of their sight for too long? So that's the whole plan regarding the mic modification. I know what I want to get it done, but it's just that a little bit of fear regarding this lockdowns and all those things which is forcing me not to do it. And having said that, the lockdown and all those things also means that we will not be able to go out. Then what's the point of modifying the bike? Because when you're not taking it out, when you're not riding peacefully in the city or something like this breakfast ride and all, then what's the point of modifying it? So all these things is running in my mind, and that's why I'm preventing myself from going ahead with the modification. And when things are right and when time is right, I'll just go and drop my bike in the workshop and give them green signal to do whatever I want to do. One last point I want to mention, I think I just told, but I would just reiterate. The AOM handlebar is definitely good. It's lot better, lot comfortable than anything that I've ever used. So as of now, I have and I think done 4 handlebar changes in my bike, and the AOM handlebar is the one which I found the most comfortable. The riding wise, this Barak handlebar, the riding position, everything wise, it is very comfortable, but owing to the gauge of this handlebar, there is a lot of vibration. I mean, just like the stock handlebar, this handlebar vibrates a lot, especially like if you're riding like what I'm doing now, like with 80 kilometer per hour kind of thing, continuous cruising. It's very evident, the vibrations are very evident. And now that I've kind of changed from the regular conventional mirror to the bar end mirror, the mirrors are like practically unusable. It flutters so much that it is like not at all usable. So that stability, not stability, that the ability to suppress that vibration, which I found was there in the AOM handlebar, and also that is also factored to do with the bar end weights, because compared to the conventional bar end weights, the AOM bar end weights were like pretty like thick and heavy. So in that way, it was able to do a lot of justice to it. But currently, I don't have a bar end weight. That could also be a factor which is causing this evident vibration. But even with the one which was given by Java, on my stock handlebar, I don't think so. It did any difference. It was more for the look rather than functional. So that's one quick point regarding the handlebar. And if given a choice, I would definitely like to go back to the AOM handlebar itself, based on the type of modification that I'm doing. Even for the scrambler look, one of the options that I have is that itself. But let's see, I'll take a decision when I get it done. But this handlebar, yes, it feels comfortable for riding. I mean, the riding position wise, but other than that, the vibration and all those things, it's no use. So that's it. That's pretty much what I wanted to tell about the modification about my bike, why I do it, and why I changed a few things over the last few months, and the reasoning behind it. Hope that answered the question in few of the folks' mind who had seen the photos and were like wondering why I did that. So yeah, that's it for this particular video. I think I spoke a lot as usual. I don't know how long I've spoken, but yeah, I spoke a lot. So let's catch up some other time with some other more sensible and valid discussion. Thank you so much for listening, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye bye.